Hello learners, this is Pankaj Agarwada and now we shall be discussing on comparison of teacher-centered, learner-centered and learning-centered approaches. Till now we have discussed learner-centered and learning-centered approaches. Now we are making a comparison across the three type of approaches, which are learner-centered, learning-centered along with teacher-centered approaches. So, in the previous lesson, we tried to understood learner-centered approaches, where learner is in the focus, learning styles, classroom processes is designed around learner. We diagnose learner's styles of learning and we plan our learning in accordance with the learner's learning styles. Learning-centered approaches, we have discussed that a process where teacher and student jointly elaborate the content, discuss the content, observe a given situation, and out of that given situation, whatever learning is happening, they complement it by discussing between the two or with the small group of their class. Today, now we shall be discussing on learning-centered, learner-centered along with teacher-centric approach. This may be a little technical, and to facilitate this content, this chapter, I have tried to present it in a tabulated form. Now, first let us understand what teacher-centered approach is. Teacher-centered approach, as the title is suggesting, that an approach where teacher is active, teacher is in the focus, teacher is in the center of the learning process. Students are mostly passive. So now we shall be relating learner-centric approach, learning-centric approach with teacher-centered approach. As I was suggesting, teacher-centered approach, here teacher is more active, and it is presumed since teacher is active, it automatically means students will be less active, or we can rather say they are passive. Discipline in the class is dictated by the teacher. So, teacher is taking control and command of the classroom situation, the content, and the students. Students become passive, content is designed, planned as per teacher's convenience, teacher's interest, and total class is under control of teacher. So, discipline in the class is as dictated by the teacher. Students demonstrate very limited interest in what the teacher is doing, since students become passive, and passive learners are not supposed to be engaged in the classroom situation. So, students become little passive, and gradually they lose interest in the classroom discussions or the activity being led by the teacher. So, teacher is doing, learner are receiving, and this activity become more silent, more disciplined, quotes unquotes, and students lose interest in the learning. Now, contrast to this is learner-centered approach, where learner is at the center of all activities in learner-centered approach. What I need to teach today, how I will teach, what will be my pedagogy, how I will connect my mental waves of my learner. All this is designed and planned in accordance with learner's capabilities, learner's interest, learner's context. The teacher plays a role of a facilitator of the learning process and an organizer of the learning situation. He or she tries to stimulate curiosity and independent thinking. Here, teacher tries to stimulate curiosity by posing small questions related to the text, related to the content for the day, or give examples or situations where students feel interested in the content being discussed. Here, students are independent thinkers. They are not supposed to be following a rigid frame of text, but they can spontaneously, they can add their examples, they can pause their questions, their situations. So they react and respond and participate in the classroom processes as independent thinkers. Here the problem solving skills automatically get space, get scope, where the teacher is pausing a situation, learners are enriching that situation with their independent thinking and trying to resolve it through discussions, through debates, exchange of ideas, reflecting on the situation, reflecting on the problem. It promotes planning and execution of project. This learner-centered approach always help teachers to plan and execute a project with active participation from the students, from the class. Also, this learner-centered approach develops self-learning involving acquisition of knowledge through observation of phenomena, creative thinking, and activities. It helps learner to observe a phenomena, observe a situation. As students are taken out to a post office, they observe the functioning of the post office, how a letter reaches our home, what are the steps between posting a letter and receiving a letter. And this observation helps learner to actually understand the situation. And through observation, post-observation, learner can have a rich discussion with the classroom, participants, with the peers, as well as with the teacher. Here, the student is free to imagine, to creatively think, if a letter is being posted and being processed in the post office, categorized into different categories, pin code wise, area wise, and what if my pin code is not written there? What if my area is wrongly mentioned on the letter? So such things came to learner's mind, which lead to creative thinking and activities. This has been suggested by National Curriculum for Elementary and Secondary Education, 1986. And this process, where learner-centric approach is going, the characteristics are learning-centered education focuses on the learning process. Teacher-centered learning focuses on teacher, learner-centered approaches focuses on learner, and here the process become important than the people. Now, neither teacher nor student, but learning becomes center of the focus, and learning-centered education is becoming focused, learning process is becoming critical. Learning-centered education places the students at the center of education. So, learning-centered education, though its primary concern is on the learning of students, it is not that learning is flowing and students are sitting aside. No, learning is flowing towards learners, where learners are performing their role, playing their activities, and all those with the students involved in the education of students, such as teachers, can also be co-learners with the students and in the learning-centered education. Learning-centered approach is basically learner-centered but includes teachers in the process of learning in the classroom situation. So, in a way, teacher-centered, learner-centered and learning-centered. Teacher-centered is focused on teacher, student-centered is focused on student, and learning-centered, where both are collectively, mutually helping each other to learn from the given situation, complementing and supplementing each other's knowledge, queries, enriching experiences. It continues with the teachers evaluating the students' progress towards learning objective, and it helps the students to acquire the basic skills to learn. It ultimately provides a basic for learning throughout life, because it's a participatory learning. It's a learning with a partnership. So both are helping each other. There can be some examples of learning-centered education practices which are like collaborative group learning, where both inside and outside the classroom it's taking place. Collaborative group learning. It can be a family group, it can be a metro passengers collectively discussing something, talking on an issue, on a hot news of the city, tea corner discussions happening where people are discussing, giving their opinion, and in the classroom where a situation is there, both teacher and student collaborative manner, collectively discussing the issue, problem, content for the day, and helping each other to have an insight about the theme. Here, individual students' inquiry and discovery become important. Like individual students' inquiry, whatever individual is asking, pausing situations, questions, and whatever individual has discovered from different sources, these become little more crucial, important, and special component, special support for the learning-centered situation. Inquiry and discovery by students and teachers together. Problem-based inquiry and learning takes place, which is long-lasting, which is supporting insight learning. It synchronizes interactive distance learning. Synchronizes interactive distance learning means where learner is relating another situation and synchronizing its experiences with the current situation. He or she might have had some experience of one situation, and today in the content he or she find his or her that situation relevant to be discussed in the class, to be brought in the class as example, as either good example or as bad example. But this can be synchronized and become interactive, help interacting the distance learning. It provides situation where hands-on experiential learning activities happen. It is not that learning is happening and neither teacher nor students are supposed to be keeping themselves distant from the process. They both become partners in the process. Thus, it is hands-on experiential learning activity. On-site field experiences are happening. Self-paced performance of contextual task. So, these are few examples of learning-centered educational practices. Now, let us understand a little comparison between the three. Let us take an aspect of nature of knowledge. In nature of knowledge, what teacher-centered approach suggests? It suggests knowledge exists prior to the learner. Learner-centered approach suggests knowledge is discovered by the learner. And in learning-centered approach, it suggests knowledge is constructed by the learner with support from the teacher. So, nature of knowledge have all three situations, all three type of learning situations, teacher-centric, learner-centric, and learning-centric. Now, what is the role of teachers and learners in these three approaches across? First, teacher-centric. Role of teacher and learner in a teacher-centric approach is teacher active and learner passive. In learner-centric, teacher supports the learner to become active, and gradually teacher become a facilitator, take a back seat. In the learning-centric approach, learner acts and teacher facilitates, means learner and teacher both are actively participating, working for the enrichment of the content in the classroom situation. Now, next aspect can be dominant teacher function. In teacher-centric approach, teacher instructions and directions are important aspect. Whereas in learner-centric approach, designing learning task and teaching is happening together. So, learner is basically in the center of designing and learning task and teaching in the classroom situation. Whereas learning-centered approach demands facilitating learning, supporting learning, actively again with the participant from teacher as well as from student. If a situation is there, how teacher-centric approach expects that situation? Teacher-centric approach suggests no such situation happens. Situation is independent and teacher is trying to control the situation. Whereas in learner-centric approach, situation is learner-friendly, where learner is feeling more confident, learner is feeling becoming active, learner is trying to control, if not control, then at least trying to shape up the situation as per his or her potential. Third situation, learning-centric, where natural and contextual learning is happening. Student and teacher both are collaborating and helping each other. So this is natural and contextual learning taking shape. Who is controlling? What factors are controlling? In teacher-centric approach, entirely teacher control, rigid and totalitarian, total control of the teacher over the situation. Teacher is in full charge of the situation and deciding what to do, when to do, and how to do. Whereas learner-centered approach suggests that control is shared between teacher and learner, partially flexible, but teacher is trying to make it inclined towards learner's potential, learner's abilities, learner's interest. And learning-centered approach demands dominantly learner controls the situation, which is flexible and democratic. Since both are active in this, so it is more flexible and more democratic. Inputs. Who is giving inputs in the situation? In the teacher-centric situation, bits of facts and knowledge are coming, flowing from teacher. So teacher is giving all the support to facts and knowledge being discussed. In the student-centric approach, inputs are taking shape with competencies and experiences from learner. In learning-centered approach, techniques and strategies of learning are gradually opening up, gradually taking shape. It is not pre-decided. Nobody is injecting something into classroom situation, but learner and teacher collectively deciding how to proceed further, how to go ahead. Now, about method and approach of learning. In teacher-centric approach, mostly it is lecture, demonstration, or authoritarian approach. In learner-centric situation, it is more playway and joyful methods. Playway and joyful means where learner is enjoying the learning, and that is the ultimate object of a learning situation. In any learning situation, the prime objective which developmental psychology have suggested is that learner should have a joyful learning experience, and that joyful learning experience is more coming from learner-centric approaches. Learning-centric approaches are activity-based. They scaffold as along with the content, along with the teacher-learner discussion, teacher-learner's participation. So it is scaffolding along with the situation. It's taking shape along with the situation. Now comes about the curriculum. Who is deciding curriculum? In teacher-centric approach, it says it is prescribed. Prescribed by some agency, some authority, or teacher himself, herself. Teacher is deciding what to be taught. In learner-centric, curriculum is developmental. Broad framework is there and it is taking shape in context with learner's needs, learner's abilities, learner's situation. And in learning-centric approach, curriculum just emerge from the situation. A reference is there, a context is there, and that context, that reference emerges in the classroom situation, take shape the way teacher and student wants to shape it up. If it's a classroom of Ranchi, maybe context is different. The framework being same can emerge a different context, different examples, different situations. And in another situation like Odisha, maybe the same context, maybe the same reference can emerge differently, because the examples, the experiences, the reflective competencies are different in one region to another region, one zone to another zone, one class to another class. To extend, I would say, one person to another person, one learner to another learner. And who is going to evaluate these competencies of teachers? In teacher-centric approach, evaluation is objective-based, which is summative. So towards the end of one exam, towards the end of one chapter, towards the end of one term, a quarter, 6 months, 1 year, and submissive exam will take place where student is supposed to mug up whatever he or she has learnt during the period of time. In student-centric approaches, evaluation takes place activity-based. It's formative. Student is deciding whatever he or she is learning, how she or he is learning, and where he or she is finding it difficult. So it is more of reformatory, remedial, where we can easily identify where learner needs to be given special attention, special focus. So activity-based formative learning, formative evaluation is happening. On learning situation, learning-centric approach, evaluation is happening with authentic assessment and self-analysis both. Authentic assessment through projects, through assignments, through written work, through some activity, and where student is self-analytical, self-reflective, self-analyzing and suggesting way to improve it. So in learning-centric, again, authentic and self-analytical becomes crucial, where both are joining hands in the process of evaluation as well. So today we have tried to understand a comparative study of teacher-centered approaches, learner-centered approaches and learning-centered approaches. In the three centered approaches, we basically focused on the ways of learning, the control of situation. In teacher-centered approach, control is with the teacher. What is discipline being defined by the teacher? What is to be taught is being decided by the teacher. On the other hand, in the learning-centered approach, learner is becoming center of the learning process. How learner learns, what method learner adapts, and how it become interesting for the learner. And as I mentioned, this is supported by NCF for Elementary and Secondary Education 1987. In learning-centered approach, we have tried to understand that learning is center. Teacher and student are collaborating not only in learning process, but in evaluation process. These three different aspects of learning situation, be it nature of knowledge, role of teacher and learner, dominant functions of teacher and learner, control of situation, who is giving inputs, learner, teacher, or it is taking shape on the spot gradually with collaboration. Curriculum, is it prescribed in teacher-centric approach? It's developed by learner-centric, and it's emerging in the learning-centric. Evaluation, collaborative. So this is today's lesson, and we'll meet again. Thank you. Bye-bye.